When it comes to sizing a solar power system, there is three main things that you need to look at. The second one is going to be choosing the right size solar panel array. So welcome back to the lab, guys. Today you are in the fifth video of a short little playlist that we put together because there was a time where we needed information like this and we couldn't find it anywhere. And in today's video, we're going to be looking at how to properly size a solar panel array. So this is actually step two in how to size the entire system. If you haven't already seen step one, go back a video, watch step one. It's about how to properly size a battery bank. I don't care what anybody else says on the internet. This is the most logical way to size your system. You start with the batteries and then you do your solar panels. So jumping right into it, there is three things that you need to consider when you're trying to choose the right solar panel array size, starting with step one, which is what are your sun hours? This is gonna look different for everybody depending on where you live. If you live in Arizona, your sun hours are gonna be a lot different than if you live in Kentucky. And that's okay, you could still build a system and a panel size that fits that lifestyle. It's just something that you need to know. It is the most important thing. On average, most places in the US get about 3 to 5 hours of good sun per day. When the sun is up in the sky, giving you nice energy, not low in the sky because it's setting or because it's just coming up. So make sure you guys do some quick research on the good peak sun hours that you get where you live, because it is very, very important. Step two of this process is gonna be determining your solar panel wattage. Now, how you're gonna do this is you're gonna go to last video where we determined our battery bank size, and you're gonna take that information and sit it down in front of you. If you watched our last video, our example battery bank size was 10,000 watt hours, and so we're gonna use that in this example video. And basically what you're gonna wanna do is you're gonna say, okay, so I need 10,000 watt hours of battery bank to be filled. Unless you live specifically in somewhere like Arizona or New Mexico and you can rely on the sun day in and day out, you're gonna wanna make sure that you fill those batteries within a day, because if you only fill half of the battery bank today and you don't get sun for 2 or 3 days, you might be out of power. So we always recommend trying to fill your entire battery bank within 1 day, and it's super easy to figure out how to do this. You're gonna take your battery bank size and you're gonna divide it by your peak sun hours, which is what we figured out in step one. So for this example, we get 5 peak hours of sun a day, but we always try to play it a little bit safe. So we're gonna knock an hour off and we're gonna call it 4. So how we would determine the wattage that we need is we're gonna take 10,000 watt hours of battery. We're gonna divide it by 4 peak sun hours. And that gives us 2,500 watts. And so if we can produce 2,500 watts of solar every hour for 4 hours, we can fill the entire battery bank. And now obviously in the first video, we talked about making sure that that battery bank can actually last you a long enough time that if you don't get sun, you're gonna be okay. Similarly here, you wanna make sure that you do an hour or two less than you actually have for peak hours, so that in case you have a couple days where it's not full sun hours, you can still make sure that you fill your bank. Solar panels still work during non-peak hours when the sun is coming up, when the sun is going down, even on cloudy days, you can still generate power. It's just not gonna be anything like what you would generate on a nice midday sunshine. And so now on to step three, you need to determine your actual array sizing. So you know you need 2,500 watts of solar, and now you get to choose how you wanna get there. So most solar panels that come with a kit that you're gonna find online from somewhere like Shop Solar or Signature Solar are gonna be 100, 200, or 400 watt-ish panels. Now obviously you could do 25, 100 watt panels, but nobody has the energy or space for that many solar panels. So you're probably gonna be looking at the 200 to 400 watt range. And so what you could do for the 2,500 watts, you could do 6 400-watt panels, which will get you to 2,400 watts, which is really, really close. I would still recommend, again, every time you do math, just add a little bit so that you're always overkill, or if you can't afford it financially, just get what you can and then build up in the future. But in this case, I would probably get 7 or 8 400-watt panels just to make sure that we have enough solar going in. And also depending on where you're putting the panels, how much space you have, or whatever your situation is, you could also do 12 200 watt panels. Similarly, I'd still buy a couple extra, make it 14, just to make sure that you have more than enough. This might not seem super important, but 400 watt panels are typically a lot bigger and you need less of them. 200 watt panels are smaller, but you need more of them. So this is one of those things where you just, when you're looking at kits, you wanna just see how big these panels are and how much room you have on your roof or on your ground or whatever system that you're trying to put it on to determine what size of panels you should get. If you just go free for all and just start ordering whatever panels, when they show up, you might be a little bit tight for space. And when it comes to solar panels, there's also a little bit of like a bonus section to this video, which is things to consider. Things that you should be thinking about while you're doing this is, now that you know how many panels you need, where are you putting them? Are you putting them on your roof? Are you gonna put them on a ground mount? Are you bolting them to the top of a van or an RV? These are also things that you're gonna need to buy. The brackets and the ground mounts and the stuff like that are gonna be things that you need to purchase to make sure that you can actually assemble this kit. So make sure you guys think about those things if you have a better space in your yard than you do on your roof. You're also gonna wanna make sure you write down this solar panel wattage of the 2,500 watts in this example, because you're gonna need this information when you come along to sizing your inverter. So hopefully that made sense. It's actually super, super easy. There's a lot of people trying to complicate it out there for absolutely no reason. So if you learned something in this video, make sure you share it with some friends who could also use the knowledge. Make sure you guys like this video. Make sure you guys are subscribed so you don't miss any of our future content. And stay tuned for the next video, because step three is honestly one of the most fun steps when it comes to properly sizing your solar power system. Thank you guys so much for watching. I will catch you in the next one. Peace out and stay charged.